Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Welcome to Diode and Application Season 2. Today we are going to discuss a Zener diode. When we add a load, what happens with the regulation of a Zener diode with a load? We will discuss different cases, different scenario for a Zener diode. For example, if our load is not connected, when we add a slightly little load, or you can say medium load, and when we connected our load at maximum load, or you can say full load condition. So first of all, let's write here our topic, that is Zener diode regulation with variable load. This is the topics that we are going to discuss today. So first of all, we are going to here draw the diagram. This is, let's say, positive and negative battery, and this is a voltage source V input, and basically there is a resistance in connected in series for the limiting purpose, for our safety of the diode and other purpose as well. This is the resistance. So there is a current. This is the current direction, and this is the ground terminal. Basically we can show the ground as well, and ground is basically a common point, and it means, for example, if I show here another, this is a Zener diode, and if I show represent this with a ground terminal, it shows that this point and this point are common point. It means there is a connection between them, direct connection. Basically, this is like this. So we can also show with the with this line. And for example, if I do not use the ground, then I can draw this line like this. So okay, this is ground, this is the purpose of the ground. There is an connection. When we want to add a load, basically this is always added in parallel with the Zener diode. And for example, this is our Zener diode, and we add our load here. This is the second terminal is grounded. It means it is also common with this point. This is connected directly with the negative. If it is variable load, then we can add this arrow. This shows the this load is variable load. And the current direction is always IL. There are two types. One is conventional current, and second one is electronic current. But directions are opposite directions, so it's not a matter right now. Our discussion is basically what happens when the load is added towards the when parallel with the Zener diode. For example, first, in this first case, we basically, this is a total current. Before further proceeding, I want to recap an important point. The Zener diode maintains nearly a constant voltage across RL. Okay, this is our RL, nearly constant voltage across RL. But this important point, as long as Zener current is greater than IZK, this is the Zener current, basically IZ. So the condition, this is the condition or requirement for this our circuit, that IZ should be greater than IZK. What is this IZK? For your recap, I roughly draw another diagram here. This is, this point is IZK, knee point, and this is our test current, normal or average current, IZ, and this is our maximum point. This is called IZ maximum. Okay, we are getting basically our regulated voltage here, VZ, at the rate of IZK, IZ. That is basically for test current, and we are average voltages here. So this is a condition. Our IZ should be greater than IZ K and less than IZM, so that we are getting the constant voltage this side. So first case, when there is no load situation, when the output terminal of a Zener diode are open, basically it means that there is no load connected. For example, we discussed this, there is nothing. For example, I hide this portion. So it means there is nothing in parallel with the Zener diode. As in our previous videos, till now we had not discussed any load or we had not added any load. So before today's video, every video there is no load. So in every video there is no load. So this situation, when there is no load, it means that RL is equals to infinite. When the load in open terminals means that always there is no connection between them and resistance is always infinite. When you connect when you do not connect your multimeter or terminals and your switch is on resistance and it always shows an open circuit or one, that shows that it's on open circuit, no resistance is connected. Okay, RL is equals to infinite. In this case, there is no resistance and open terminals. And the load current is always zero. This is across the load current. We cannot find the load current basically because there is nothing here. First of all, I show that I total is basically IZ plus IL. This is resistance is connected in the circuit in series. You can see that this is the series path. There is no additional path available in circuit for the connection with the positive terminal. So it means that this is the only path, and in this path there is a resistance. It shows that this resistance is basically in series. So this resistance is connected in series. In series, you know that the current remains the constant. So this IZ will be constant for throughout the circuit. Okay, second important thing right now, this portion, if you focus, I will show this portion with another pointer. For example, this portion is in connected in parallel. There is a multiple paths available towards the ground. So it means that in this portion, that's why we basically use the parallel circuit. We connect our load in parallel with the Zener because in parallel our voltage will be constant, and we want from the Zener diode basically regulation of the voltage. So basically that's why we use. For example, this is our voltage VC and we are getting a constant voltage in this portion, and in this portion basically in parallel this voltage is constant but the current will be divided. So that's why I show this current is IZ and this current portion is IL. So for further proceeding, this information you should keep in mind. So this is connected in parallel. So the total current in this case is IZ. This current is IZ and it is divided here in IZ. This is I total and it is equal to IZ plus IL. And in this case, when there is a no load and this is an open case, no IL is involved, then it means that I total is equals to IZ only, because IL, there is no RL. So if there is no RL, there is no IL involved or V across this. It means that I total in this case, when there is no load, is equal to IZ, and you can say that here IL is equals to 0 ampere, okay, at no load condition. So condition 2, when the load is added. Load is added but with a high resistance, RL is high. It means that our resistance is high. The resistance, higher the resistance basically means that our load is small. If the resistance is very small, it means just like a short circuit, our resistance is very high. Our load is very high. The lower the value of resistance basically shows that the lower the value of resistance, keep in mind, higher load. The value is, if high, it means that lower load. For example, if it is open circuit, the resistance is so high that we write it is infinite. Basically it is very low load. So when the lower load, resistance is high, RL is high, And at this point, when the load resistance RL is added, some part of the total current now is basically divided in IZ and IL. So the total current right now is basically IZ plus IL. Now there is something, that's why we cannot ignore IL right now. The total current through R is still constant. Total current through R is constant, but there is R is constant because this R has constant voltage. Okay, so if there is a change in the voltage in here, then this will not be constant. IT is constant because there is a situation that you can say that regulation. Until our diode is in regulation state, we are getting basically IT here constant. Total current is constant. The total current across R is constant because our diode has in regulation state. When the diode is in regulation state, it means that we are basically getting a constant voltage. So if our voltage is constant, so we can say that our total current is constant. So I can show you with the help of using the Ohm's law. According to Ohm's law, we can basically apply Ohm's law here because this is the linear resistance. So linear resistance, Ohm's law is basically applied on only on ohmic devices. So we can say that resistance is basically ohmic device. We can apply the linear resistance, we can apply the Ohm's law on ohmic devices. So linear resistance is included in the ohmic devices. V is equals to IR. Basically I here, we want to find I total, that is V over R here. R is constant. For example, this is 10 ohm. At no load conditions, still it is 10 ohm. At load conditions, still it is 10 ohm. So R is constant. Its value is defined. That's why we say that this is a linear resistance. Constant. There is no change. But when we talk about our voltage, that is the only here factor involved that can change the value of I total. But I said that when this diode is in regulation state, it provides us a constant voltage. So constant voltage means that this is a constant until it is changed. Voltage is changed only in this scenario if our diode will be not in our you can say that regulation state. So this is a condition you should have to maintain a regulation in order to have a constant current across R. Okay, if we basically lose our you can say that regulation, then no current will be changed. Okay, now moving toward condition number 3 and our last condition 3. At full load condition, what is our full load condition? Our full load or maximum load condition is basically when we increase our load, and higher load basically means that if our load is high, our resistance is low. If our resistance is decreased, resistance is now decreased. RL is decreased, low resistance is connected. If RL is decreased, it is understood that IL is increased. Why IL is increased? This resistance is low, the total current is divided in these two portions. This resistance is low, more the current will flow from this resistance because it allows more linear path or more easy path for current to ground. You can say that this positive, you know that current always follow the simplest path or easiest path. So if resistance is decreased, it will show a linear path or easiest path towards the ground. So current will be higher from this side except this side. So IL, this is an if you want to see another proof, for example, then you can say that IV is equals to IR once again using Ohm's law. Okay, if I want to increase in this case, we decrease our resistance, our current will increase to maintain a constant voltage. For example, for easier understanding, I can write I is equals to V over R from this, changing this to in this form. From here you can easily see that if a current and resistance have an inverse relation, I is inversely proportional to 1 over R. Okay, if our current is increased, our resistance is decreased. Same is the scenario here. If our resistance is decreased, our current is increased. So our current in this case is increased. It shows that our load current, that is load. So load current across load is increased. If this is increased, our IZ will decrease. See how I total is equals to IZ plus I load. This factor is constant. Let's say we are not changing this factor. If total current is same, but if load current is increased, our this portion is increased. To maintain this balance, this equation, our this factor will be decreased. So if this factor is decreased, it means our IZ is moving towards IZK. IZ decreases the value of IZK basically towards IZK. That it means our current is to moving towards the our knee of the curve. So we have to we have to make sure that our current will not cross our this point, that is knee point. So if our current will reach its minimum value, that is IZK, for example, this situation occur IZK. This situation occur. This is the extreme situation. It is not recommended to operate the diode in this situation. But let's say this is an our extreme situation, and this is if our value will go below by to till IZK, by increasing this value IL to maximum. This is the maximum. If we go even a little bit further, mean milliampere further, further increase, then our IZ will decrease and our regulation will be lost, total lost. So this is the maximum value, and we can find our maximum value by this using this relation, and we will discuss an example further for our better understanding, but in next episode, because already time is very very less time in this episode. I use maximum time, but I'm very hopeful that maybe you pick my points that I want to explain in this episode. So better next time explain an example. So we'll discuss an example next time for using these concepts. In this video I show you, but remember that there is no simple case, or you can say ideal case is discussed. And example I will also explain the ideal case only for simplicity. From the next episode I will discuss a complex case, that is the complete, or you can say practical model diode, in which we also consider the impedance of the diode. So we will discuss further discussion next time. So watch, learn, grow. See you next.